Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1998, Pivot Table Year Over Year. I'll be podcasting this entire book. Go click that I in the top right hand corner for the Mr. Excel XL playlist. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, the first topic in the book about pivot tables, and it's how to create a year over year report. So we're starting out with the data set that spans 2 years. You see, we go from 2018 through 2019. I'm going to create a pivot table. Insert, pivot table. Okay, that lets it go to a new worksheet. On the new worksheet, we're going to take the date field and drag it to the rows area. And then you see in Excel 2016, it automatically groups things up. Now, I know most people are still in Excel 2013, maybe Excel 2010, so I'm going to press Ctrl+Z to undo. That's the experience you'll get in 2010 and 2013. We're going to take the revenue field and drag it to the values area. So we start out with an ugly report that's going to be hundreds and hundreds of rows because it's every single day that we had sales. But I'm going to go to the very first date field, go to the Pivot Table Tools Analyze in 2013 or 16. In 2010, it was called Options, and choose Group Field. Make sure that you choose a date before you choose Group Field, and roll things up to months and years, or quarters and years, or months and quarters and years. Click OK, and what we get is a new virtual field called Years down here in the Rows area. Now, some annoyances. It's annoying that they don't give us year totals. It's easy enough to fix that, although in my case, I don't need to fix that. But we click Field Settings and Automatic, because I'm not planning on leaving the years here. Of course, every time I create a pivot table, I go to Design and say Show in Tabular Form to get everything into its own column, and then repeat all item labels to fill in those blanks along the left-hand side. Again, that wouldn't be necessary here because I'm not planning on leaving the years where it is. I'm going to take the years and drag it over to the columns, and that's the report that I was shooting for. All right, so we have months going down the left-hand side, 2018, 2019. In column D, what do I really want? I don't want a grand total. I'm going to right-click and say remove the grand total, and now we're outside of a pivot table, so percentage change. Very tempting to build this formula using the mouse or the arrow keys, but you can't because you'll get the get pivot data function, which does not easily copy. So equal C5 divided by B5 minus 1. We'll format that as a percentage and double click to copy it down. All right, beautiful report showing where we were last year, where we were this year, and then the percentage change from year to year. Well, this tip and 40 others are all in this book. Go ahead, click that I in the top right-hand corner and buy the book. All right, so you start off with a data set with multiple years. Do Insert, Pivot Table, drag the date field to the row area. If you're in Excel 2016, press Ctrl+Z to undo their automatic grouping of dates. Why don't we just leave this here? Well, it actually depends. If you would have data from, let's say, January 2nd through December 30th, they're not going to group that data correctly. It has to span an entire year for you to get the year field. It might be that it works out for you. I'm a bit of a control freak. I'd rather just have control. That's why I undo theirs. Drag the revenue to the values area. Select any cell, any date in the row area, and then group field. Choose months and years. Drag years over to the column area. Right-click the grand total to remove, and then build a variance. Typing the formula, don't use the mouse or arrow keys. I have no idea how to pronounce it, but thanks to this reader for suggesting this tip, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.